Just before we start, before our welcome, I want to make some announcements for your information. As you're all aware, we need to follow some protocols because of the COVID. Please make sure that you check in. That's number one. Preferably, if you have the mobile phone, do it with your mobile phone. If you don't have your mobile phone, please write your name on the sheet that is provided there for you. Also, I would really appreciate if you could all put your mobiles on silent so we don't have any interference here during the service. Also, bathroom facilities just behind this building there in a corridor. If it's not enough, there's extra toilets downstairs. Just keep in mind also as much as possible to keep the distance, minimize touching and hugging each other. I know it's hard on occasions like this, but we need to make sure that we comply with all the regulations. So very much appreciated. Thank you for that. And we want to make sure that everybody stays healthy and well. I'd like to welcome everybody here. You know, the sweet singer of the Lord, David, in one of his psalms, I'd like to imagine that at some stage he was singing it. But these are the words that he used. And he said, "Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints." And we are here today, beloved, to pay our respects to one of those saints. And judging by the amount of people that is here, I think you agree that indeed, look, you don't mind if I call her Mima. To all of us, she was Mima. Mima was one of his saints. And we want to celebrate her life. She was loved. She was loving. She was always ready to give everything. And we need to remember that. So on behalf of the family, I want to thank each one of you for making time to be here this morning. And not only you here, but also the ones that are watching on live stream, wherever you are, different parts of the world, we are thankful that you are there. So may the Lord bless us all as we pay respect to our beloved Mima today. To open our meeting, I would like us to sing this beautiful hymn, Rock of Ages, which is hymn number 111. 111. Thank you. We are blessed to have Rock of Ages that we can hold on. I would like to invite Brother Larry to come forward to open our meeting with a prayer. Please remain standing as you are, and we are going to have our opening prayer. Thank you, Brother Larry.
Dear merciful, loving Father, we give you praise and glory forever for all the things that you've done for us. As we come together in thy throne of grace this morning, Lord, we're not normally here on this day, but we are here for a time that we have to say goodnight to our mother, grandmother, sister, and a friend, and as an auntie, Mima, to us. We pray that you'll be with us, your Holy Spirit will be among us and comfort every heart. We pray that you'll be with the family and Brother Ilic as well. We pray that you'll be with each and every one of us here, family and friends. Comfort us with your Spirit. Remind us about the hope that you're given, and you promise that you're coming back to take us all home. We thank you that you'll be with us today. Forgive all our sins and be with us in the beginning of this memorial service till the end. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. I just want to also mention, I forgot to do that, wearing of the masks is compulsory unless you are exempted. So please, if you're inside, you need to wear a mask. Now, the order of our memorial service will be in two languages, especially the message of hope. It'll be on Slavic language and also in English. And we are very glad and happy to have Pastor Rajko Švonja here with us, and he will start us off.
Dragi Aco, dragi Danko, Branko, Ivane i ostala ožalošćena rodbino, draga braćo i sestre, mi smo došli ovdje iznenada zbliženi jednom žalosnom činjenicom da iz svoje sredine moramo da otpratimo nekoga ko je bio drag, nekoga koga smo voleli, poštovali, cenili kao suprugu, kao majku, kao baku. I sve nam se nekako čini kao da je ona tu živa među nama, ali stvarnost je drugačija nego što bi iko od nas želeo. Naša draga sestra Mira je sklopila svoje oči, prekrstila svoje ruke i pošla na svoj privremeni počinak. Prije nego što potražim reči utehe i ohrabrenja, želeo bih da otvorimo u svetu i dragu knjigu koju je ona itekako volela, poštovala i cenila i čitala, i da pročitam reči 90. psalma. Gospode, ti si nam utočište od koljena do koljena. Prije nego se gore rodiše i sazda se zemlja i vasiljena i od vijeka do vijeka, ti si Bog. Ti povraćaš čovjeka u trulež i govoriš, vratite se, sinovi ljudski, jer je tisuća godina pred očima tvojim kao dan jučerašnji kad mine i kao straža noćna. Ti ih kao povodnjem odnosiš. Oni su kao san, kao trava koja rano vene, ujutru cveta i uvene, a uveče se pokosi i sasuši. Dana godina naših svega ima do 70 godina, a u jačega do 80 godina. I sam je cvet njihov muka i nevolja, jer teku brzo i mi odlećemo. Nauči nas tako brojiti dane naše, da bismo stekli srce mudro. Ovo su reči utehe i ohrabrenja klonulim ljudima tokom vekova. Čitajući ovaj psalam saznajemo da je život čoveka na ovoj zemlji zaista muka i nevolja. Godine teku brzo i ljudi odleću jedan za drugim. Svaki rastanak sa onim koga smo voleli, koga smo cenili i poštovali je zaista tužan. I jednostavno, kada god se rastajemo, uvek nam suze dolaze na oči. Ta žalosna istorija umiranja prati ovu planetu već skoro 6000 godina. A ono što je tužno jeste da danas umiru i mladi i stari, da umiru i bogati i siromašni, i zdravi i bolesni. Svi redom, smrt nikoga ne štedi. Dok jedan umire u cvetu mladosti ili u punoj snazi, drugi umire ojađene duše, skrhan bolešću ili starošću. Ljudi još nisu uspeli da pronađu lek za smrt. Međutim, postoji još jedna ozbiljnija misao. A to je, pored činjenice da smo svedoci još jednog završetka života, reči ove svete knjige nas podsjećaju da ćemo se i mi jednoga dana naći u istom položaju. To je ozbiljnost veća nego što mi mislimo. Uprkos tome što ljudi to ne žele i vrlo često nešto dobro isplaniraju, dogovore se i odluče, iznenada dolazi bolest, dolazi smrt i sve to prekida. Svaki trenutak života nosi u sebi promjenu prema smrti. I upravo zato mnogi ljudi podižu svoje oči ka nebu i kao da vape i pitaju se ima li pomoći. I evo psalmista odgovara, kaže, evo to je naš Bog, to je onaj koji jedino može spasiti čovjeka. On je moćni, živi Bog koji vlada univerzumom, koji je živeo prije nego se gore rodiše, prije svake tvari. Jedan od najlepših zapisa o njemu nalazi se u Evanđelju po Jovanu, 3. poglavlju, 16. stihu, a siguran sam da ga svi vi znate na pamet, jer Bogu tako omilje sve da i sina svojega jednorodnog dao, da ni jedan koji ga veruje ne pogine, nego da ima život večni. Jer Bogu tako omilje svet. Iako je nekada davno pojava greha razdvojila čoveka od Boga i kao posljedicu donela smrt na našu planetu, dobra misao, ohrabrujuća misao za nas ovoga jutra jeste da se pojavio neko ko je preuzeo ovu kaznu na sebe. Neko ko je platio cenu, neko ko je umro da bismo mi mogli živjeti, neko ko je pobedio greh da bismo mi mogli biti pobednici. A to nije niko drugi nego naš spasitelj Isus Hristos. Dragi moji, ima li lepšeg ohrabrenja za čitavo čovečanstvo? Za vas, dragi ožalošćeni, Isus je umro za našu dragu sestru Miru. On joj je otkupio od osude zakona. On joj je poklonio mogućnost života večnoga, a ona ga je prihvatila kao svog ličnog spasitelja. Ona mu je verovala čvrsto. Ona je sledila njegovu reč, Sveto pismo. Ona je živjela u toj nadi i u toj sigurnosti, i njeno srce do posljednjeg trenutka je grejala ova nada da će Hristos doći, da je On umro za nju, da će On njoj dati život koji više nema smrti, nema rastanaka i nema kraja. To je unosilo mir i spokojstvo u njen život. To mogu da imaju svi ljudi. Kaže apostol Jovan u 1. Jovanovoj 5.12. Ko ima Sina Božjega, ima život. Prema tome, psalmista kaže, nauči nas tako brojiti dane naše da bismo stekli srce mudro. Šta to znači, dragi moji? To znači pripremati se za večnost koja će se uskoro otvoriti. To znači da će Krist svojim glasom podići sve one koji su umrli i da će im dati život u ovoj nadi skorog Hristovog dolaska zaspala i naša draga sestra Mira. To znači, misleći na večnost, upravljati svoj život prema ovoj svetoj knjizi, Bibliji, oponašati život Isusa Hrista, truditi se da budemo slični njemu u karakteru, to je ono što on očekuje od nas. Znati kako treba živjeti, kako te nas Bože naučiti, Bože reći da naučimo brojiti dane svoje, znači sebe predati Bogu, poveriti svoj život u njegove ruke, čekati da on dođe i da nas uzme zauvek da budemo tamo gdje je i on. To je upravo učinila naša sestra Mira. To je nada, to je uteha koju nam daje Spasitelj u ovoj svetoj knjizi. Jedan lepši, jedan bolji život. Život gdje nema smrti, gdje nema bola, gdje nema suza, gdje nema rastanaka. To je poruka vama, dragi moji ožalošćeni i draga braće i sestre, iz ove svete knjige. I zato, opraštajući se od naše drage sestre Mire, ne možemo da ne postavimo sebi pitanje ovoga jutra, na čijoj smo strani. Da li smo na strani onoga koji je izazvao greh i smrt, ili smo na strani onoga koji je sve učinio da bi spasao čovečanstvo, a to je naš Spasitelj Isus Hristos. Svako od nas, ljubazni, mora odgovoriti na ovo pitanje. I zato veoma je važno da shvatimo da od odgovora na ovo pitanje zavisi i naša budućnost. Život ili smrt. Sudbina tvoga i moga života je u našim rukama. I zato drago mi je da mogu ovoga jutra da vas ostavim sa ovom radosnom notom. A to je da je sestra Mira sledila Isusa. Trudila se da je stavi na prvo mesto u svom životu. Da ga stavi. Neumorno je proučavala Bibliju. Jačala je svoju veru kroz te divne, snažne reči Isusa. Uvijek je bila spremna da se odriče u korist drugih. Uvijek je bila vrlo optimista, nasmejana, vesela. Sećam se dok smo imali predavanja u Holroyd centru, javna predavanja, dok je nas posjećivao doktor Terzin i drugi, ona je uvijek dolazila, uvijek je bila vesela, nasmijana, sa svakim se pozdravila, svakoga je ohrabrila, redovno je bila u crkvi i nikada nije izostajala sa bogosluženja. Naravno, nije ovo sve lepo što bismo mogli reći o našoj dragoj sestri Miri. Biblija kaže da ne žalite kao ostali koji nemaju nada. Dragi Danko, Ivane, Branko, imali ste divnu majku. Zaista, vodila vas je Bogu, poučavala vas je hrišćanskom životu. I to je velika prednost koju ste uživali. Dragi Aco, imao si divnu suprugu. Proveo si divno vreme sa njom. Mnoge godine, ali sada ona je zaklopila svoje oči i polazi na svoj privremeni počinak. I zaista, svaki rastanak je tužan, ali i najteža bol zbog razdvajanja može se ublažiti nadom da ćemo se ponovo videti jednoga dana. Uskoro kad naš Spasitelj dođe na oblacima slave i kada svi sveti anđeli dođu sa njime, i kada glas arhanđela se bude čuo, tada će i ona ustati i ponovo ćete se sresti sa njome i u zagrljaju i u sreći večnoj i radosti poći, na oblacima sa Gospodom. Neka Bog dragi uteši vaša srca ovim rečima psalma i neka vam Bog da snage da prođete kroz ovo teško iskušenje rastanka, tuge i žalosti. Neka vas ove reči hrabre, vode i teše. Amin.
Thank you, Pastor Schwonio. In English, Message of Hope by Pastor Nathan.
We come here today to remember. You know, looking at the photo here on the program, that's the face that you see, the smile, just ready to go, you know. I mean, she's smiling there, but that's the default smile. Then there was always that ready to smile and to say some kind word. That's the Mima we remember, no? Does God see when one of his children goes to rest? Jesus said that not even a little sparrow would fall out of the tree to the ground without our Heavenly Father noticing. Does he care? Jesus, who holds the keys of death, who has life in his hands, came to the graveside of a friend. And he was also touched with our emotion and our sadness. And even though he was about to raise Lazarus, it records in the shortest verse in the Bible that Jesus wept. I think of dear Mima and I think of several things. First, I think of her priorities. I was asking Danko, did she have some hobbies, you know? And he thought and he said, you know, not for herself. Not for herself. And he couldn't think of, but I think she had hobbies, but the hobbies weren't the ones you normally think of, right? That, because everyone loved her for her hospitality, right? Everyone loved the kolaches, you know, the cakes that she would bring and the things. Everyone loved that, yeah? And she was very social. So I believe she had other focused hobbies, right? That was life for her. But you wouldn't think of as a hobby. She was the shoulder to cry on. She was the one who was there for you. What did she do? Well, she was a homemaker. Well, there's a lot behind that word, you know? She would help many people. And there was a story posted the other day that I happened to see someone. They were telling a story from the old country that they needed something. They were in a situation. They were stuck. And she said, come to our town. We'll sort it out for you. Come stay with us. You know? And I'm sure there are many, many stories like that. That was her. Do you know, I suppose there are many different things in life that can consume our priorities, but Jesus was asked, of course, by someone who was, you know, it was a theological discussion, but it was asked, which is the great commandment of all the commandments in Scripture? Jesus knew what the right priorities were because he said, the first one is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, your mind, and strength. This is the first commandment. He was not asked about the second one, but he himself gave us the second one. And what was it? It was love others as yourself. Love your neighbor as yourself. And he said, there's no other commandment greater than these. People many times get absorbed in rituals and when it comes to spiritual things, caught up in many things. But Jesus himself told us that loving God and loving others is the most important priority in life. And having known Mima for a few years since I've been in Australia, I'm convinced that that was her priorities. Loving God and loving others. And she set us a wonderful example in that. And my second point is almost like the first. She loved people. Do you know, in all the visits that we made together, we would combine every bit of English that myself and her husband could and herself could muster, and every bit of Yugo, of course, that I could muster, you know, and we would have a conversation. But even then, you know, you couldn't always connect all the thoughts you wanted to express. But there's another language which we all speak, and we all can hear, and we all can feel. And that's the language of love. And I find that she was very eloquent in this language, the language of love. And you could always understand her expressions of love. One day I was here, and those who know my oldest son, he finds it difficult to be in crowds of people. He was having a difficult day. When he had sort of settled down and was a little calmer, she came over and she patted him on the head and she said, "Good boy. He's a good boy." And even on, you know, on other days that weren't such a bad day, she repeated that phrase, "Good boy." She showed a care and love for him, and that was her way to say, "It's going to be okay." And she figured, he's a good boy. She wanted to be here in Australia when they came across for her children, who had already all come. And people were very important. I understand that she always wanted a daughter, and didn't matter the order she kept putting in. With God, she kept delivering sons. But, you know, I think about that. She has many daughters now, right? And so I reckon she was pretty happy with that. She has many daughters. She loves each one. You know, that's God. He loves his children, and he loves her. It says, "Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints," in the Psalms. And so, I suppose it's the love of God that brings that together and is expressed in the love to one another that helps us to remember what love is really about. Love is really about understanding that person and caring for them and sympathizing, looking out for their needs, and putting them first. And that love, it says in the apostle wrote, that there's nothing in the world that can separate from love, from true love. And he mentions many things, death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, it says, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And he teaches us, Jesus teaches us, and Mima taught us what love is like. And we treasure that, don't we? So I think about her priorities, I think about the people in her life, and I think about her relating to pain and to peace. She's old enough to remember the war, the Second World War. She remembers, she was just about 6 years old when the war finished. She remembers soldiers being in their home, and she went through all of that. But, you know, during that time, she experienced the loss of her mother at only 4 years old. I can only imagine what that must have been like. She did gain a stepmom when she was 11. And she's known by many as a mother of three. What some may not know is that she's a mother of four. That Ivan was a twin, and his twin was stillborn. And so Mima experienced joy and pain at the same time. even though we miss her. We know she's at rest. The scripture says, "Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them." It's a blessing for her to rest. And we experience the joy of the memories that we share and the example that she gave us, but also the pain of that loss. It is natural to feel sad because of this loss. But we're reminded by the great apostle in another passage not to be sorry or to be sad as those who do not have hope. It is natural to sorrow. It's okay. It is what we feel as human beings. But let us not be sad as those who do not have hope of the future. For we have a promise of a future where we shall be reunited. Where those that have died will be raised again. Those who have lived through to the coming of the Lord will be resurrected. And it says that we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with those that have died in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. We will be together once again. And he finishes saying, "Wherefore, comfort one another with these words, that we will be together again." I also understand that Mima loved to travel. And I think about that. Why did she love to travel? Yeah, she liked to see places, as we all do. But she loved to see people. There's one great trip it's going to be the trip of her life, and that is to visit, to go to the house of our Heavenly Father and to see everyone again, right? And we will all be together. And it says in the book of Isaiah that every single week on the Sabbath, that in the new heavens and new earth, God says, "It shall come to pass that from one new moon and from one Sabbath to another shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith the Lord." So a minimum of meeting together. She used to look forward to coming here on a Sabbath day and to see not only her family, obviously, but all the friends and many that are here today. She used to love to come together. So it made the last couple of years more difficult because those opportunities were fewer. And so that's going to be her joy, to be together with everyone again. And we are promised in Revelation 21 that God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And God will make all things new. And he says, these words are true and faithful. It is a promise that you can count on. So as we think of her priorities, especially the people in her life, and the fact that she experienced both pain and peace, and now she rests, we can think of all these things and ask ourselves the question, what am I looking forward to? What are the priorities I make in my life? What place does God have in my life? What place do loved ones and special, important people have in my life? Do I treat and treasure those in my life well, and remember that every day is a gift? Am I thankful for the gift of pain and the gift of peace? Do I have an eternal perspective? We are told that eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. We can hold on to that hope while we also treasure the memories that we have. And may we, I think if each of us can be at least a fraction as loving as she was, that life would be much better. So may we be challenged by that example and blessed by those memories and share that same hope. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Nathan, for that beautiful message of hope. And, you know, to fall asleep in a hope that you will see your Lord soon as you wake up, it's something wonderful. And we are all looking forward to the time that we will see each other again. You know, I don't know about you, but I love to hear about the story of the lives. And there are many things, yes, we know her very well, perhaps, but there are so many things that we still don't know. So we are looking forward to the eulogy. And I'd like to invite Ivan to come forward. And you're going to come together, come. So we'll have it in Serbian, and then we're going to have it in English. Thank you.
Very overwhelmed with all of you who have come. We thank you for taking time off to say goodbye to Mima, as everybody knows her. We know it's probably not understood by everybody, but for the sake of families who are not here, especially overseas, instead of having, is it all right? Okay. Thank you. Instead of having translation, we were blessed that we have two speakers, pastors that speak in Serbian and also in English. So please bear with us if you don't understand everything because we're not translating from Yugo, but that's where English comes in. So about eulogy, we'll have Ivan to read first in Serbian and then I will follow in English.
Mira Jugović Ilić rođena je 8. marta 1938. u Jazavici kod Novske kao najmlađe dete Ivana I Reze Jugović. Imala je dve sestre I dva brata. Marija zvana Seka rođena 1927. Mio rođen 1929. Zora, rođena 1933. I Zdravko, rođen 1935. Svoju mamu je izgubila rano u svom životu. Bila je samo 4 godine kad je njena mama umrla 1942. Njen tata Ivan se ponovo oženio 1949. godine sa mladom udovicom Mandom, koja je sa sobom dovela sina Milana, koga smo zvali Uja Milan. Godine 1952. cela porodica se preselila u Borovo zbog boljih ekonomskih uslova. Tu je Mima srela svog muža Acu Vladimira, za koga se udala 13. aprila 1956. I došla da živi u Metković. Taj njen put u novi dom nije bio previše dugačak, malo više od 100 kilometara. Ali kao dosta mlada nevesta od 18 godina imala je veliki izazov da se prvo uklopi u domaćinstvo koje se sastoji od tri odrasla muškarca, muž, svekar Čeda I dever Rada. Zatim tu je nova okolina, nove komšije, malo drugačije tradicije I stil života. I upravo ti rani izazovi su je korak po korak spremali za život pomaganja drugima I probudi u njoj talent da u pravo vreme kaže reči ohrabrenja I utehe onima kojima treba. Kao jaka, prijatna i društvena osoba, vrlo brzo se uklopila u novu sredinu. Ako je Mima posle udaje mislila da život sa tri odrasla muškarca stavlja nju u manjinu, rađanje tri sina nije baš unelo balans u njen svet. Danko je rođen 1958. Ivan 1961. i Branko 1964. Malo poznata činjenica da je Mira rodila četiri sina. Ivan je blizanac i njegov brat je, nažalost, umro na porođaju. Danko i Rozeta su se venčali 1980. godine. Imaju dve ćerke, Vivien i Lana. Ivan i En su se venčali 1990. godine. Ćerka Lucinda i sin Luis. Branko i Dragana su se venčali 1987. godine. Sin Jesse i ćerka Bianca. Vivien i Chris su se venčali 2012. godine. Lana i Jeremy su se venčali 2012. godine. Jesse and Maria su se venčali 2020. godine. Gostoprimstvo je bilo nešto u čemu je Mima uživala, a njeno kuvanje i kolači su bili njen proizvod kojeg su uživali mnogobrojni gosti i poznanici. Njen talent organizacije je došao do izražaja tokom 7 sabora svake 2 godine u našem dvorištu, kojem je prisustvalo između 500 i 700 posjetilaca u zavisnosti od godine. Taj period je toliko bio upečatljiv za našu mamu da je ono duboko zavoljela Metković i stanovnike celog sela za neverovatno gostoprimstvo koje su pokazali. Ona je često znala reći: Bog je dobar i sve vodi. Zato mu hvala za ove divne komšije i njihovo toplo gostoprimstvo u prihvatanju stotina gostiju na smeštaj. Bez njih ne bi bilo moguće ugostiti toliki narod. Zbog njene stalne želje da bude drugima od pomoći, stvorila je mnogobrojne prijatelje, ne samo u Metkoviću, nego i u daljinama da se prostiru na raznim kontinentima. Te snažne prijateljske veze je neumorno održavala bez obzira gde se nalazila. Mnogi ste svedoci njenih telefonskih poziva. Samo da kažem par reči. A naš tata Aca je te pozive opisivao sa: Eno Mira, opet tanji žice. U skladu sa njenim privatnim duhom, mama je uvek bila vesela i znala je kako i u tužnom društvu da postavi osmeh na lica oko nje. Mama je volela putovanja, ili u prevodu, nije se plašila da putuje. Kao što bi to mnogi rekli, oko nje sa zaključkom: lako je njoj kad ona došla iz daleke zemlje. Probajte zamisliti da je neko 105 kilometara tako daleko. Kad smo mi jedan po jedan odlazili prema Australiji ili Kanadi, njeni prijatelji su u čudu pitali zašto ona ne pokazuje tugu. Mi znamo da je to samo bio njen talent glume. Njen odgovor je bio: samo neka idu, pa ću ja videti sveta. Inače, mama je pre nas putovala u Ameriku, jer su tamo živeli njen tata i braća. U avgustu 1992. Mima se preselila sa mužem u Australiju da bi bile bliži svojoj deci. Tu je odmah po dolasku dobila naziv Mima od unučadi i tako je svi znaju. Kao u ranijem iskustvu, i ovde se jako brzo uklopila i još više proširila krug prijatelja koji su takođe uživali u njenom društvu i naravno kuhinskim proizvodima. Iza nje ostaju tužni, ali sa jakom verom u Hrista I uskrsenje. Muž Aca, sinovi Danko, Ivan I Branko, njihove supruge Rozeta, En I Dragana, unuci I unuke Česi, Vivien, Lana, Bianca, Lucinda, Luis, Zetovi I snaje Chris, Jeremy I Maria, Deverada, bliža I dalja rodbina I mnogobrojni prijatelji širom sveta.
Mira Jugović Ilic, known to most as Mima, was born on the 8th of March, 1938 in the town of Jazavica, near Novska, the youngest daughter of Ivan and Reza Jugović. She had two sisters and two brothers. Maria, known as Seka, born 1927, Mio, born 1929, Zora, born 1933, and Zdravko, born 1935. Mima lost her mother at an early age. She was only 4 years old when her mother passed away in 1942. Her father remarried in 1949 to Manda, who was a widow herself and had a son, Milan. And as Ivan just mentioned, he was part of my mom always said, this is your uncle. So we knew him as Uncle Milan. In 1952, the whole family moved to Borovo for better work opportunities. Here, Mima met her husband, Aca, full name is Vladimir Ilic, and they married on the 13th of April 1956, after which she moved to Metković. Her journey to her new home wasn't very long, a little more than 100 kilometers. She arrived as a young bride of only 18 years and had to quickly adapt to living in a home with three grown men, her husband, her father-in-law, Čeda, and her brother-in-law, Rada. At the same time, she had to familiarize herself with new surroundings, new neighbors, along with slightly different traditions and lifestyles. The challenges she faced during her early years in Metković prepared Mima for a life of helping others, and she developed a real talent for knowing exactly what to say at the right time to encourage and console those who need it. Being the cheerful and friendly person that she was, Mima was quickly accepted in her new surroundings. If Mima felt outnumbered, living with three grown men, the scales were really tipped when she had three sons of her own. She was still even in greater minority. Danko was born in 1958, Ivan in 1961, and Branko in 1964. A little known fact is that Mima actually gave birth to four sons. Ivan is a twin, but his sibling was stillborn. Danko married Rosetta in 1980 and had two daughters, Vivian and Lana. Ivan married Anne in 1990 and they had two children, Lucinda and Luis. Branko married Dorothy in 1987 and they had two children, Jesse and Bianca. Vivian and Chris were married in 2012, and 6 weeks later, Lana and Jeremy were married. Jesse and Maria married in 2020. Yeah, just look at this. In 6 weeks, we had two happy occasions that Mima loved more than anything else. Mima loved to extend her hospitality to others, and her cooking and cakes were a product of her hospitality that were enjoyed by many visitors. She was a talented organizer, which was demonstrated during the 7 conferences across 14 years held in our backyard, where between 5 and 107 people attended, depending on the year. During this time, Mima developed a deep love for Metković and its community, which welcomed our visitors with open arms. She often said, "God is good and he directs everything. I thank him for our wonderful neighbors and the warm hospitality in receiving hundreds of guests. Without them, it would have been impossible to accommodate this many people." And because of her eagerness to always help those around her, she made many friends not only in Metković but also in faraway places on different continents. She untiringly maintained those deep friendships regardless of where she was. Many of you were recipients of her phone calls, just to say a few words. Mateo Ded Aatsa described these calls as, "There goes my Mira, straining the telephone cables." In keeping with the positive spirit, Mima was always happy and knew how to brighten any gloomy situation with a quick wit and smile. Mima loved to travel, or as some have said, she wasn't afraid to travel. Also, especially neighbors, would say, it's easy for her to travel since she comes from far away. Imagine 105 kilometers being considered far away. As we, one by one, moved away to Australia and Canada, her friends would ask why she didn't seem sad. But we knew she was just good at acting. Her answer was, "Let them go. It will give me opportunity to see the world." In any case, Mima was the first of us to travel abroad. She went to America a few times to visit her father and brothers. In August 1992, Mima and her husband moved to Australia to be closer to the children. This is where her children christened her Mima, which is how many of you know her. Actually, when they were deciding how to call her, she said, a few of the relatives back home find it easier to say Mima. And as grandchildren, he accepted that. All of you probably know her as Mima. As early in her life, she quickly adapted in Australia, expanding her circle of friends who also enjoy her company and culinary skills, collage. Though heartbroken at her passing, we have faith in the hope of Christ and the resurrection. She is survived by her husband Aatsa, their sons Danko, Ivan and Branko, with their wives Rosetta, Anne and Dot, her grandchildren, Jesse, Vivian, Lana, Bianca, Lucinda and Luis, and their spouses, Chris, Jeremy and Maria, her brother-in-law Rada, and many family and friends from all over the world.
Thank you, Danko, Ivan, Branko, for sharing your mom with us also. And I have learned some things about her that I didn't know. And truly, she was a remarkable lady. And we are very happy to have her with us for a while. Thank you for that. You know, what struck me always is the bond that Mima had with her grandchildren. And it was amazing to see the love between the two. And there were many times that we witnessed, well, I personally witnessed, when they would meet, the hugs and cuddles and kisses. And I'm sure that you have felt blessed to have a grandmother like that. And she was blessed to have wonderful girls like and boys like you. And I think we have a special item now from Lucinda and Bianca that want to share something with us. Thank you.
Odrasli smo sa roditeljima i sa bakama i dedom. Mislili smo, oni će uvek biti sa nama. Sad smo shvatili da se ta cijela celina polako prazni. Mira Ilic stvarno je bila savršena žena. Živela je sa mužem, deverom i svekrom dok nisu došle tri nove duše. Rodila je 4 sina, 3 su ostale. Držala je u redu ne samo svoju kuću, nego i cijelo selo. Ljubav koja je zračila iz sveg srca bila je sa nama do zadnjeg dana. Blagoslov su joj bili 6 unučadi. Jesse, Vivian, Lana, Bianca, Lucinda i Louis. Volela nas je, ali nas je i riktala. Kad je život postao tegoban, zaboravan, nije zaboravila da nas voli. Djetinjstvo mladih Ilića je nezaboravno. Ništa joj nije bilo teško. Za vreme školskog raspusta strpala bi nas u auto, svi 6, i odvezla nas vikendicu. Kolače je bilo u izobilju. Nijedan rođendan nije bio propušten. Gostoprimstvo u Radostan 8. bile su mimine vrline koje ne iščezavaju. Uvak nas je zvala da vidi kako smo. To će nam nedostajiti. Volela nas više nego išta na svijetu. Uvek nam je govorila, niko nema što Mima ima. Mima ima svoju dječicu. Bila je ponosna da smo često zajedno i da se slažemo. I u ovim teškim trenucima probat ćemo da ostanemo familija. We start our lives with our parents and our grandparents. And we always expect they will be there to the end with us. But unfortunately, these days come. Mira Ilic, what a woman. She lived not only with her husband, her father-in-law, and her brother-in-law, but then she birthed 4 sons. This woman kept her house, her men, and the whole town in order. She was then blessed with 6 grandchildren, Jesse, Vivian, Lana, Bianca, Lucinda, and Louis. And man, did she keep us in order too. She loved us with all her heart, and we felt it right through to her last days. Even though her last few months were a struggle, we always felt loved. No one had a better childhood than the Ilic kids. Nothing was too much for her. During the school holidays, she would pick up all 6 grandchildren and take us to our holiday house up the coast. We all know Mima loved baking cakes. She never missed anyone's birthday. She was the most hospitable and always happy and smiling. She would always call and check in. We will miss these calls. She loved us more than anything in the world. And we knew it. As she would always say, Niko nema što Mima ima. Mima ima svoju dječicu. We will continue being there for each other, even through these hard times. We were a close family, and she was always proud of this. We love you, Mima.
Izvinite ako ne kažem sve pravilno, probat ću. Mima, ima toliko stvari koju mogu reći, toliko stvari želim da kažem i toliko uspomena. Teško je obuhvatiti ženu poput Mime koristeći samo reči. Bila je sila na koju se moralo računati, a znati Mimu značilo je voliti je. Mima se brinula o svima nama dok smo odrastili i uvek je bila veoma prisutna u našim životima. Svaki rođendan, školske prezentacije, venčanja, bilo koji važan događaj koji se setite, ona je bila tamo. I mogli biste da garantujete da će Mima biti tu sa najmanje dve veoma važne stvari. Osmehom i kolačima. Bila je tu i u manjim trenucima. Onim tišim, kada smo bili samo mi. Porodične večere, šetnje do parka, putovanje do Jumajne. Mogli biste da garantujete da će i tada biti kolači. Mima je bila naša stena. Porodica joj je bila sve. I volila nas je celim srcem. Čak i pred kraj, u trenucima kada nismo bili sigurni da nas se potpuno seća, nikada nije zaboravila da nas voli i da smo joj važni. Videli smo to u njenim osmecima, u načinu na koji nas je grlila ili pružala ruke, ne želeći da ih pusti. Mima je imala dubok uticaj na moj život. Njen uticaj, njeno saosećenje, njena ljubav, njena velikodušnost pomogli su da me oblikuju u ono što sam danas. Sigurna sam da nisam sama u tome. Taj deo sebe koji je podelila sa nama, vrednosti koje je usadila i bezuslovna ljubav koju nam je pokazala je nešto što će ostati sa nama do kraja života. I kroz to će njeno nasljeđe živjeti. Mnogo sam volila svoju Mimu i nedostaje će mi više od svega. Nedostaje će mi njeni zagrljaj. Nedostaje će mi njen osme i nedostaje će mi njeni kolači. Nedostaje će mi sve o njoj. Mima bi uvek govorila, niko nema što Mima ima. Kao da se osjećala srećnom što nas ima. Ali iskreno, mi smo svi bili srećni. Mima, there are so many things I could say, so many things I want to say, and so many memories. It's hard to encapsulate a woman like Mima using only words. She was a force to be reckoned with, and to know Mima was to love her. Mima looked after all of us growing up and was always very present in our lives. Every birthday, school presentations, weddings, Any important event you can think of, she was there. And you could guarantee that Mima would be there with at least two very important things. A smile and kolache. She was there in the smaller moments too. The quieter ones, when it was just us. School pickups, family dinners, walks to the park, road trips to Humana. You could guarantee there would be kolache then too. Mima was our rock. Family was everything to her, and she loved us with her whole heart. Even towards the end, in the moments when we weren't sure she fully remembered us, she never forgot that she loved us and that we were important to her. We saw it in her smiles, in the way she would hug us or hold our hands, never wanting to let go. Mima had a profound impact on my life. Her influence, her compassion, her love, her generosity helped to shape me into who I am today. I'm sure that I am not alone in that. The part of herself that she shared with us, the values she instilled, and the unconditional love that she showed us is something that will stay with us for the rest of our lives. And through it, her legacy will live on. I loved my Mima very much. And I will miss her more than anything. I will miss her hugs. I will miss her smile. And I will miss her kolache. I will miss everything about her. Mima would always say, Niko nema šta Mima ima. Like she felt so lucky to have us. But in all honesty, it was us who were the lucky ones. Thank you.
I really felt love, and I think you all felt it, how much you love your grandma. And I have witnessed how much she loves you, and I'm sure that she will be missed. You know, the Bible tells us not to sorrow as do others, but he never said not to sorrow. So don't be ashamed to shed a tear, because when you love somebody so much, they are in your heart. And she will be there for a long, long time. But also remember, though, stay faithful to the end, and you will meet her once again. And we all want to do that. We want to see Mima again. We are going to have a slideshow now. It's always nice to see some beautiful pictures. So thank you very much, Chris. Beautiful. That last little note, nobody has what Mima has. And that is so true, that love in her heart. We have a few minutes left for volunteer tributes. About 10 minutes altogether. So if somebody would like to say a few words of their memories of Mima, you are very, very welcome. Come forward here or put your hand and I will invite you to come through. Who would like to be first? You can put the lights back on if you don't mind. Who would like to be first? Thank you, Joe.
Memories of her, like many of you, is that she always had cakes and she always remembered my birthday. And, she always remembered my birthday. That was really nice of her. And I'm glad to have known her and her sons and brothers.
Thank you. Thank you, Joe. Anybody else? Thank you very much, Brother Yunel. You know, there are so many memories. We would be here number of days if we are going to all share. But please, if you want to say a few words, just be ready, because we don't have much time. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I moved to Sydney in 2004, and someone opened arms and called me my son. And always, if she make a cake, something for their children, I'm doing something for Yonel too. Doesn't matter if I was sick or not. Some I cannot explain, just thank you for having a mom.
Thank you. You know, there was probably never a time that I remember when she was here on a Sabbath, there was no cakes. Very, very rare. And people are so used to it that, you know, where's the cakes? If they're not there, what happened? Is Mima well? There's no cakes. So that's one thing that we all remember her by. But her kindness is amazing. And I know my grandchildren benefited by her remembering their birthdays and giving a little bit of a gift for them too. And everybody loved Mima. Next, Sister Rishko.
Thank God for the courage. I met Mima in my life first time in 2019 IT, when Rosetta and Danko was married. And since that time, when they come to Australia, and Mima, when that I don't go before that, when my husband passed away 25 years ago, Mima was my company. The same time when my husband died, months after that, Rosetta and Danko, they went overseas. And I had Mima there calling almost every day. We have some visitors, you come. We go out, come with us. When her children called her, she said, not without Oma. I want Oma with me. And so I was the spokeslady, and they were my company. wherever they need in those days, they were. Their children were young, so I took them wherever, doctors, this, that, there, and so on, and till today. From time to time, I get a call, and even there, from hospital, about Mima. I said, sorry, you have to call her children. And so, God gave me strength that I could stand here today. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Rishka. Anybody else? Brother Kraus?
In 1988, my wife and I visited Yugoslavia for the first time. We went to Staro Pazva. There was a conference, about 600 people were present. So I went early on Friday to be able to film the people as they arrive. Danko was then in Australia and I knew him and his feature. And I saw this man coming along. And he came closer and I filmed him. And as he walked past me, I said, Kako si, brad Ilic? I said, hello from Danko, Australia. So later on, when his wife came past, he said, this brother, Australia. On Sabbath morning, Sister Ilic was serving coffee for breakfast. And so I went with my cup, and again, she that big smile, and she's still here, Australia. So she gave me a cup of coffee. I still taste that coffee and smell that aroma now. When I went back to Europe, I said, I want to buy that coffee. I bought a kilo, but I can never make it like her. So this is my memory, that smile, that taste, and that smell. Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Kraus. Next. I just want to mention something that it really left a long-lasting memory to me personally, and that is every time I ask Mima, how are you? You know what she says? Biće bolje, it will be better. Well, she was right. Now it will be better. When she wakes up to the everlasting life, it'll be better. You know, she went through hard times for the last couple of years. And it's never nice to be sick and to suffer and not to live a normal life. But if you look forward to the blessed hope, you can cope. And she always looked beyond the troubles. It will be better. And I always remember this. I will never forget it. If there is nobody else, your last chance. Thank you, John, Brother John.
Very sad to be here, but I'm very sad to be here, but I'm very glad to be with the family. My daughter Natasha is 35, so she was just one, and we're passing through Yugoslavia to Romania. My daughter Natasha was 30 is 35 today, and we passing through Yugoslavia, and we stop at Mima's place. You know, I cannot describe you, only heaven. I cannot remember two mushrooms that time, but I remember they were plucking plums, the seeds from the plums, and the joy, and the happiness, and the cream, and the bread, and the bed, and this, I never been welcome nowhere in the world like in that family, like Mima, and the husband, and other people there. And we went to Romania, we come back to her place again. And that inspired me, you know, with many things in life. And today is our last day together. But you can imagine at the wedding of the Lamb in heaven, how nice it'll be to be for eternity with Mima. Thank you.
Thank you, Brother John. Last chance. Thank you, Brother Larry, and we have Jesse too. Thank you, Jesse.
My memory of Auntie Mira, Mima, is when they had the accident here on Schofields Road. Since that time, I was privileged to go and pass by on Wednesday to pick them up, to bring them to Wednesday prayer meeting. And I can say that she may not remember my birthday, but almost every Wednesday I pick them up, there's always a bag that she always bring. It's either a bread, the roll, or you know, a wafer that we're bringing. And I said, okay, if she bring it a little quick, I will put it in a Neski I have next to me so that the children will never see that, but they always quick to see it. And there was one Wednesday as well that we were there to pick them up. We were carried away with something that we were talking about with Brother Ilic. He was there in a car, and also as well Oman was there as well. We were carried away with whatever we were talking about, and we were waiting for her for a while, and then Brother Ilic ended up said, oh, I'm going to go and check on her. Why it takes so long? And then she came back, they came back to the car, and he came back and said, oh, he was cleaning the house. But as we were waiting to pick them up to bring to prayer meeting, she was worried, cleaning up everything else, thinking that we were going to come inside as well. But we remember all of you in our prayers, and we know exactly how you feel losing a mom in your family as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesse. The tallest grandson, definitely.
Thank you. I just wanted to read a poem that Lana wrote and did the answer. Naša Mima je nekako znala kako da priča ona sa nama. Njene reči prevodit ne treba jer ljubav njegov sreća bila je sa neba. I sad razumemo zašto je to bilo tako. Sve što je iz njenog srca razumemo je svako. Ne postoji dovoljno reči da opisem tu. Koliko je ljubav naša Mima imala u sreću, srcu. Pa i sada da razumete svi, osme ljubavi na liču će se pokazati. I tako je ona bila uvek nasmejana. Punog sreća, ljubavi, veselja i radosna. But one thing that I think we'll all remember and appreciate with Mima, especially us cousins, was she was cheeky at times and a risk taker. And I remember, I don't know if our parents know, but when she'd take us up to Yamina, we would have been, what, 8, 9, maybe 10? And she'd be like, all right, Vivian, Jesse, go to the beach. And off we'd go, and Mima would be making lunch, and she'd say, come back in a bit, and there'll be lunch. So she never worried about any predators or anything. I don't think that sort of existed back in her time. So she'd just say, off you go, and there we are, 6 kids just running to the beach, running around wild. People probably saw us thinking, what are these guys doing? And one of the fond memory I have with Mima, I was working around the area once, and I came there to visit. And she says, are you hungry? And I said, no, I just ate. Like, I had a big lunch, and I was here, so I thought I'd come and say hi. And she goes, no, you have to eat my food. How can you not? Are you telling me you don't want to eat my food? I'll say it both in Yugo, so Dada knows too. Jedan dan ja sam išao kod tvoj kuća da vidim Mima kad sam radio. I ona mene kaže, jesi gladan? Ja sam rekao, ne, puno sam jeo. Ja sam sit. Ona kaže, pa šta, ti ne voliš moj rana. Nećeš ti jedeš. So I said, all right, Mima, I'll eat. So she comes and she pulls out all this food, sarma, salad, potatoes, everything, and she fills my plate full, and I eat it. Ona izvadila iz frižider sve hrana, sarma i sve, pravila veliki tanjir od hrana. And I ate all that food, and then she piled it up again. And I said, I really can't eat. And she goes, are you sure you don't want my food? Like that, she nearly started crying. So I said, all right, fine, I'll eat it again. Then she brings cakes. And she made, my favorite cake was this apple cake. And she puts the cake down, and I started eating. And she sits on the chair finally, and she looks at me, and she goes, Jesse, you're getting a bit fat. So, posle ja sam imao taj prvi tanjir, Mima kaže, trebaš još. I onda natovori još jedan tanjir. I to je pun hrana. Ja kažem, neću. I ona kaže, pa jedi. Ja sam jeo. Onda ona dobije kolači, ona je imala taj kolač, ja sam volio sa jabuka. I ona daje meni kolač isto i ja kažem, ok, samo jedan. I ja sam jeo malo i Mima sedi dole i gleda mene. I onda kaže, joj Jesse, malo se ugojiš, a? That's it, thank you.
I think we are going to close with this. Thank you, Jesse, so much. And the wonderful memories. And yes, that was Mima. And we are so glad again that you were able to come to witness the love and loveliness that this sister left behind, Sister Mima. I'd like to invite you to sing a closing hymn, which is hymn number 695. Does Jesus care? Oh yes, he does. Jesus cares. 695. Thank you. wonderful song, He Cares. He sees your tears, He sees your grief. And may the Lord bless you and strengthen you by knowing that He is there for you. Our closing prayer will be offered by Brother Nathan.
Our Father which art in heaven, in our grief and in our pain and in our loss, we thank you for comfort and for peace. That dear Mima is resting, and we take her now to her final resting place. We also claim the promise of courage and strength as we go on, especially those who are nearest to her. Heal the hurt, but thank you for the memories and the love that we treasure, and we pray that that legacy may live on and that that love may continue to be shared. Thank you for comfort. Thank you for love, for family, for friends, and this opportunity we have to share. May we never forget, and may we have that always in our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Just a couple of announcements before we proceed to the cemetery. Castlebrook Memorial Park, which is Rouse Hill opposite the Main Shopping Center on Windsor Road. You're very welcome to follow the hearse, otherwise make your own way there. Aim for 12:30, I think this is the aim, so about 12:30 to be there. At 2 o'clock, those that would like to come back here for refreshments, is going to be held here in Schofields. So I'm for 2 o'clock to be back here. So this concludes our program in the church. Thank you. Paul? Okay, so it's going to be also live streamed at the service, same link. It'll be a different link. Okay, it'll be shared, so second link. It'll be live stream for those that were watching on a live stream. Thank you.